of our brothers and sisters in Christ from different countries around the world. And what they bring with them is a sense of tradition, cultural heritage, and through that, a lot of it is expressed through music. So for the last 10 years, I've been glorified in hearing different rich cultural sounds. And so tonight, you'll see a snapshot of what rich blessings our diocese has.
My name is Sylvia Bright, and I am a freshman here at Bishop Ireton High School. My parish is at St. Louis, and I am introducing the Ghana Catholic Community Choir. The Ghana Catholic Community Choir of the Arlington Diocese currently worships at the Plain of Apostles Catholic Church in Alexandria. The choir has been in existence since 2003 and currently has about 45 dedicated members, with four directors, namely Godfrey Hafer, Bernard Atta Botang, Francis Kai Bafour, Alfred Darko. The first song is performed by the choir is titled Ayi Ra, meaning the Lord of Faith. The second song is titled This Is the Day. Both songs are sung during Easter period and show our gratitude and praise to the Lord for having died on the cross, so that our sins might be forgiven and for rising from the dead on the third day and rejoice with all. Ladies and gentlemen, the Ghana Catholic Choir.
Thank you. Well, without further ado, let me introduce our next group. Actually, let me introduce my next students, plural, I think, I think there's two of them this time. We'll be introducing our next choir. So for the Holy Martyrs of Vietnam Combined Choir, please welcome Sabrina and Francesca Leoncio.
Oh Lord, walk with me.
Oh Lord, walk with me.
Thank you. presence of so many wonderful people. So, but it is my wonderful pleasure to introduce which of my students is introduced in the St. Joseph's Choir. Okay, so that's one. So, it is my pleasure at this point to introduce one of my star freshmen, Monet Chappelle, who will be introducing our next choir. So, please welcome Monet Chappelle.
Gospel music into the Mass at the historic African American Church in Alexandria, Virginia, which is celebrating its 100th anniversary this year. Before you know more about the choir, it's fitting to hear about St. Joseph's Parish, which had its beginning during the era of racial segregation. Back then, in the early 1900s, Black Catholic worshippers in Alexandria were restricted in their place in the church. Mother Catherine Drexel, founder of Sisters of the Blessed Sacrament and heir to the wealthy Drexel family in Philadelphia, donated $8,000, no small sum in 1915, toward the construction of the Mission Church in Alexandria. The parish was staffed then, and remains staffed today, by the Josephite Order of Priests and Brothers, a religious community founded in 1871. With a commitment to serve the African-American community. To find out more about the parish, visit us at our Sunday 8:30 and 11 a.m. Masses, or go to our website where you can find all about our many activities during our year-long centennial celebration. When the St. Joseph Choir debuted in 1976, little did anyone know that God's plan would widen its level of service outside the St. Joseph community. Today, the choir is regularly requested to sing for masses and in concerts and services at churches throughout the Washington metropolitan area and beyond. For several years, the choir joined in with its African brothers and sisters for annual diocesan unity mass sponsored by the Office of Multicultural Ministries. Twice, first in 2002 and again in 2013, the choir raised its sounds of praise in the Arlington Diocesan Cathedral of St. Thomas More. In 2011, the choir sang during the Diocesan EWTN televised pilgrimage to the Basilica of the National Shrine of Immaculate Conception in Washington, D.C. During biannual cruises since 2008, the choir has sung at stops in the Caribbean Islands, in Barbados and St. Lucia, and in Spain and Italy. The choir has also traveled many years to Raleigh, North Carolina to appear in a concert that benefits foster children in surrounding Wake County, and has wrapped up weekends by providing music for the Sunday Mass at Raleigh St. Joseph Parish. Several founding members continue to lend their vibrant voices to the choir. Through the years, other St. Joseph parishioners have become proud, thankful additions to the choir's decades-long tradition of service. The ensemble has compiled a wide repertoire of music spanning traditional and contemporary gospel, spiritual hymns, and anthems. The St. Joseph Choir remains fully committed to delivering joyous shouts of praise and soft, comforting harmonies of blessed assurance in the name of the Creator, Father, His redeeming Son, and the comforting Holy Spirit. The choir, led by long-term director Eugene Harper, will sing two selections today that resonate and reinforce the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. The first, entitled "I Have Seen the Lord," recalls the scene of the empty tomb and the wonderment of those who witnessed it. The second, "Resurrection Jubilee," joyously proclaims that we all tell the world that Jesus is risen and the world is in the world today. It is my great pleasure to introduce the St. Joseph Gospel.
Thank you. did not hold him down. Thank you.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Ako po, si Yomi Altahar. Ako po ay nasa pang-apat na taon dito sa Bishop Ireton. Ang aking parokya ay Primo Apostles ng Matatagpuan sa Alexandria, Virginia. Good evening to all. I'm Marty Altahar. I'm a senior here, as Father Bresnahan said. And my whole parish is Primo Apostles. Nais ko pong ipakilala sa inyo ang Filipino Serenata Choir, also called Philippine OLGC and Friends, galing sa Our Lady of Good Counsel. So Webster's 1913 dictionary defines serenata as a piece of vocal music, especially one of an amorous subject, a serenade. The Oxford Dictionary's website defines serenata as a cantata with a pastoral subject. Serenata also happens to be a combination of the words serenade and canta, canta being the Filipino word song. Hence the birth of serenata, Filming OLGC and Friends. Serenata Filming OLGC and Friends was established in October 2013 by the Filipino Ministry of Our Lady of Good Counsel Church in Vienna as a takeoff of the then Filipino Choir of All Saints Parish in Manassas. The group, under the leadership of Choir Director Nia Regis, is currently composed of members of the Filming OLGC family and friends from OLGC, All Saints Parish, and other parishes around the Metro Washington, D.C. area. Serenata provides liturgical music primarily to the Filipino community at masses and special events, such as the annual Simbang Gabi Novena of Masses in December, and the San Pedro annual Simbang Gabi Kalungso Memorial Mass in April, held at OLGC. The group occasionally sings at the monthly Filipino Masses, held at St. Bernadette in Springfield, and at the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Immaculate Conception, for the feast of Our Lady Antipolo. The church has also sung at wedding and funeral masses. This evening, Serenata will sing two works composed by Father Manoli Francisco, a Filipino Jesuit priest, and popularized in the Bukas Palad Music Ministry. The first composition, Awit ang Pagsuyo, is a song of affection for our blessed mother. The second, I Will Sing Forever, is a song praised with chanting inspired by African tradition. For the Mother Mary, for our Lord, and for all of you, Serenata.
Pakinggan mo,
inawa
Es un placer para invitar mi amiga y mi estudiante, Jaslyn Galindo, que... Ok, perdón. Un poquito. ella es una freshman, no sé, la primera nivel, no sé. There you go. I tried. But it is a great pleasure to introduce our next Ireton student, Jaslyn Galindo, who will introduce our next awesome choir.
Me llamo Jaslyn Galindo y estoy en mi primer año aquí en Bishop Ireton. Mi iglesia que voy cada domingo es San Luis en Alexandria. Good evening. My name is Jaslyn Galindo and I'm a freshman at Bishop Ireton, and my home parish is St. Louis Catholic Church in Alexandria. Tonight, I'm introducing the Hispanic Charismatic Choir. Almost 4 years ago, an Oración Tierra Nueva prayer group from Renovación Católica Carismática from the Diocese of Arlington, God has given them the opportunity to sign up during the Asambleas in the parish of Good Shepherd Catholic Church in Alexandria. Since this time until now, they have had participation in their group every Friday, where they meet prepared to God for the needs of the community. Recently, their director from Hispanic Apostolado Hispano, Father Jose Eugenio, invited them to participate in this event. The group has said that it was prize for them because in their Hispanic groups from Renovación Católica Carismática have a lot of groups with more experience. So they still give thanks to God and Father Hoyos for the invitation and opportunity to perform. They are interested to evangelize with the music, their community, and to sing to the Lord because He is good and His love has no end. The first song that they will perform is called Ángeles de Dios, Angels of God, written by their Catholic songwriter, Darwin Letchler. The song should remind us that God is everywhere, and we sing to the Lord when we pray to our Lord. His angels are coming down to us and raising our prayers to Him. Please invite this choir to rejoice with your angels and to sing to the Lord. Open your hearts and sing with them. Come with your angel and celebrate because God is here. The second song you will hear them sing is called Tú Eres Todo Poderoso. The only reason. This is a rock version from a group, Choral, which reminds us to give adoration to our Lord, praising God because He is almighty, great, and majestic, and much more. Recently, this choir has adopted the name Lua, which named by Father Hoyos, meaning breath of the Holy Spirit. The coordinators tonight are Jamie Hilario and Ivan Segadio. Disfruten del concierto. Gracias.
Madre la sal. Rapidly approaches on April 30th, 2015. Although we have adopted America as our home, we still consider ourselves in exile and long for our homeland. This song especially represents our sentiment as Canadian Catholics. As ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Heart Song Stand and Gag.
Một đất Việt Nam, một dân tộc Việt Nam, một tâm hồn Việt Nam, một truyền thống Việt Nam. Là người Công giáo Việt Nam, con phải yêu Tổ quốc cấp một. Chúa dạy con, Hội Thánh bảo con, cha mong dòng máu ái quốc sôi trào trong huyết quản con.
do incredible performances, incredible singing. Thank God for your parents, and thank you. I would be remiss if I didn't thank my awesome and incredible group of students who bravely dared the spotlight and presented these choirs for you. So if you could give a round of applause for my awesome students. But I would be very remiss if I didn't introduce on behalf of the Diocese of Multicultural Ministries, Office of Multicultural Ministries. I think I got it right. There's a lot of words there. English was not my strong suit. And so I would be remiss if I didn't introduce the woman who has put everything together and has been so instrumental in making all of this happen, Mrs. Corinne Manon. No.
Well, that's not quite true. I fortunately did very little when it came to putting all of this together tonight. There are so many people to thank. And so first and foremost, if you turn your program over, I'm just going to go through really quickly and thank those verbally here that really made tonight possible. First of all, our Bishop, Bishop Paul Liberty. He couldn't be with us here tonight. But in his place, I just wish to extend you a gratitude for your attendance here tonight. His loving support of the Office of Multicultural Ministries is the first part of the foundation that made tonight happen. Second, Dr. Thomas Curry, who is the principal of Bishop Ireton. When we first approached this collaborative effort, he was game and eager for this to happen tonight. Lastly, we'd like to thank, not last, but Peter Davey, Joe, and Bishop Ireton's staff and students, as Father indicated. But we found some other important people here at Bishop Ireton that really helped us out here tonight, and that would be Kevin and the technical crew. So could you please give a huge round of applause for Kevin Curry and the Bishop Ireton technical crew. If you saw Liz or I laughing tonight, we were on these headsets, and you know, they do everything with such professionalism and then a twinge of humor. And so what a fantastic job and professional job they do here at Bishop Ireton High School. I'd also like to thank our Episcopal Vicar for Faith Formation, my boss, Father Tom Ferguson. Again, his love and support of the multicultural ministries has really fostered and made tonight possible. Tim Cottmore and Dr. Richard Gabala, and I'll come back to him in just a second. I'll do it right now. Dr. Gabala, can you make your way down to the stage? Dr. Gabala is our diocesan music coordinator, and he has a lot of areas that he's involved in. And when Liz and I first proposed this idea to Dr. Gabala, he didn't tell us no, he didn't tell us that we were crazy, and he didn't try to stop us, which was a fantastic thing. In fact, he gave us the encouragement and support to make it happen. This just came about late January of this year. So all of what you see here tonight was only under a few short months. And so without Dr. Gabala's support, we wouldn't be here this evening. So as a token of our appreciation, I was behind the scenes for this event. There was somebody else that really took the lead. She stepped into a leadership role, the first one I've seen her step into, very professionally, articulately, and organized every single piece of what you see here tonight. From the parking map to arranging for the choirs to get here, all communication with each and every choir, this young lady really rose to a very nice senior leadership position in organizing this entire event. She is the program assistant for the Office of the Multicultural Ministries. I'm heartfelt and blessed to work with her every single day. And truly, she made each choir look amazing, as well as she's a Bishop Ireton alumni. So please, let's bring Liz Coffey up on stage. Liz, come on. So if you enjoyed any of the music you heard here tonight, guess what? It's available on a monthly basis around our diocese. So you can just go to the Office of Multicultural Ministries website, check out the mass schedule, we'll put up some performances there as well, and you'll be able to hear maybe your favorite choir, if you have one, here tonight. So now we're ready for our final number. And I would also like to, as we get ready for our final number here, thank the individual choirs. We are so richly blessed in this diocese to bring our Catholic faith from across the globe.
Please welcome my wonderful freshman friend, Haley Hogan.
My name is Haley Hogan, and I'm a freshman here at Bishop Ireton. I go to church at First Baptist in Alexandria, and it is my pleasure to welcome back to the stage all the choirs who have performed today for our finale. During the Easter season, we recall the great joy of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. With the whole church, we boldly proclaim his victory over death, shouting Alleluia, which means praise be to God. The word Alleluia echoes across continents, sung by every culture and people. And so, it is fitting that at the end of this concert, which unites so many cultures and traditions, we should join our voices in singing a song to praise our risen Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, singing Celtic Alleluia by Christopher Walker, please welcome the multicultural choral combined cop choir.